1 year. So we'll have to continue working at that. So happy I don't. It's hard to be happy when you didn't win, but we're making progress.
You said it was a feeling out process for you in terms of, do I want to ride the hot hand? Do I want to try to distribute carries? Kind of what went into that for you this week in terms of, maybe I guess with Justin and Kennedy?
You know, we got into the game, and again, as we started going, I would like to sub after a couple series at least. You know, when Justin started, let him get a few series in the game and kind of get a feel for it and kind of get his blood flowing and then be able to get him out so that you can get Kennedy involved in the game, as well as making sure that we're kind of monitoring a pitch count, if you will. Obviously, we know it's a long season, so the more reps that they each get, including Martell, the better we're going to be, you know, healthier, fresher. We get, you know, we got in a situation where we played 94 snaps, 89 countable. That's, you know, it's tough for any individual player to play that many snaps. So whether it be a hot hand or just rotating through is the goal.
Would you like to see Martell get a few more touches?
Touches, however that flows, sure. But reps, yes. You know, I need to do a better job of making sure that I get him in the game a little bit earlier and give him an opportunity to play a little bit as well. He's earned that.
Being that this was obviously the first game with you coaching with the guys, how do you feel that communication was or that in-game stuff was being the first game with the backs?
I thought it was pretty good. You know, like I say to them, you know, when we line up and play on Saturday or Sunday, in this case, the work is done, you know, so hopefully I've done my job in getting them prepared through the course of a week. And, you know, obviously going to this game, we had several months, and then as we turned our focus to Virginia Tech toward the end of camp, that I've done my job in preparation. So they were really good on the sideline and being able to communicate, them communicating with me and letting me know what they were seeing and what was happening. So it was good, I thought. We can always improve, but it was good, I thought.
And still a lot of yards there for Justin, considering what the defense was giving you guys. Would you have liked to see the backs be able to get out more and, you know, get maybe more into the red zone, more touchdowns, but that's just what the defense was giving you? It wasn't able to be successful?
You know, I thought Coach Bell called a heck of a game. And there were, and obviously, you know, I think for the most part, the decisions that were made on the field were really good ones when the quarterback was given run pass options. And he took what the defense gave him. Like we understand that the more success we have on a perimeter, it'll eventually open up lanes in the run game. And, you know, sometimes, you know, it's been talked about all through camp and since January about the running back situation here. So there'll be people probably geared up, you know, to try to stop the running, which will open some other areas in the perimeter up. So, you know, they gave us those opportunities. Will did a heck of a job executing. And, you know, so going forward, it'll help us.
And now going into the home opener this weekend, what are some things that you're looking to see out of those guys up against TCU?
Continue to improve. You know, you hear a lot of times that the most improvement during the season happens between week one and week two. So hopefully that still is true. And so hopefully we can improve on the things that we're doing and then continue to grow as a group and, you know, continue to do the fundamental things the right way and just execute. You know, it all comes back to execution. And Coach Ferguson said that to the team last week. You know, we need to worry about us and make sure that we're doing the right things collectively as a team and then individually in the position groups.
And Tevin got in, made a couple nice plays there for you. What are you looking at of him in terms of progress? How would you like to see him improve?
Continue doing what he's doing. And like I said, Coach Spavital does a great job with creating matchups and coming up with plays and packages to kind of feature guys or give guys an opportunity to make plays. So I think going forward, as we continue to game plan, I think, you know, Coach will have some things and packages that will use Tevin's ability. So we'll see week to week. And then obviously at some point he'll get in the backfield and have an opportunity to carry the ball as well.
Was there, so Kennedy and McCoy got the bulk of the snaps the second half. Was there a specific reason when Justin did so well on the first?
No, just, you know, when we started second half, Justin started the game. So typically I would go back with whoever started the game. And then depending upon how the game goes, if he tells me he needs a blow, then we'll get him out. If not, then at some point, depending upon the series, we had a couple long drives, you know, and, you know, sometimes it's harder to sub within a drive because you don't want to mess up the tempo. So that, you know, so we have to kind of be careful with subbing. So they did a good job once they got in there, and they needed that, you know, for the conditioning part of it to continue getting in shape. You know, it's a long season.